Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope everybody's doing well today. So today guys, I want to go ahead and do a teaching, and I want to go ahead and start with a disciple who followed Jesus. He was one of the 12, and his name was Thomas, also known as Didymus. And Didymus is also known as, in Hebrew, the twin. So if you can turn with me to John chapter 20, verse 24 through 29. But Thomas was one of the 12, called Didymus, was not with them when Jesus came. The other disciples therefore said unto him, We have seen the Lord. But he said unto them, Except I shall see in his hands the print of the nails, and put my finger into the print of the nails, and thrust my hand into his side, I will not believe. And after 8 days again, his disciples were within, and Thomas with them. Then came Jesus, the doors being shut, and stood in the midst, and said, Peace be unto you. Then said he to Thomas, Reach hither thy finger, and behold my hands, and reach hither thy hand, and thrust into my side, and be not faithless, but believing. And Thomas answered and said unto him, My Lord and my God. Jesus saith unto him, Thomas, because thou hast seen me, thou hast believed. Blessed are they that have not seen, and yet have believed. There is a great lesson to be learned from just reading these short scriptures. And those who are in the fence about believing that Jesus Christ is Lord, who are doubting their faith, who are doubting if they should walk with Jesus or not, there is no doubt at all that Jesus Christ is Lord. Jesus Christ knew Thomas's heart, Thomas wanting the proof. He not only wanted to see Jesus, but he wanted to touch him and to feel his side. He did not accept the disciples' witness. He wanted himself to see Jesus. As disciples of Christ, I know that some Christians have seen Jesus face to face. There is no doubt that Jesus can make his appearance before people, and he has done that with many people in the Bible, with many of his servants in the Bible, such as Moses. Jesus talked to Moses face to face. Now Jesus also was face to face with Thomas. But Thomas, he had doubt. You know, he wanted to believe that Jesus rose from the dead after his crucifixion. He wanted to see for himself. And he was a little over the fence about accepting the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Kind of like, you know, being double-minded in some ways. You know, he was believing, but he was also kind of faithless at the same time. And this is an important lesson because, you know, we're in at this place where a lot of people are trying to figure out if they should follow Christ or not. Should they follow Jesus? Should they follow the Messiah, the truth, the light? And in scripture, in the Bible, it says, choose this day who you will serve. Are you going to serve God? God gives us a choice. He either wants us to serve him or serve the world. We know the consequences of serving the world. Even Christians who decide to backslide, who decide to give up, who become faithless, sometimes will fall into the deception and the traps of the world. And if we continue in that path, it's really hard to get out of it. It's like going into a deep pit and you're not able to see the light. So to avoid that type of situation, to avoid being in a place of darkness and being in a place of isolation or being in a place of being hopeless, our remedy is to draw closer to God in the midst of hardship, in the midst of chaos, in the midst of uncertainty, in the midst of hopelessness, in the midst of depression, in the midst of sadness and grief, in the midst of being alone. We have to rely on God Himself, because when we lose things, when we lose everything, what do we have? Our self-worth comes from Christ Himself. We are the embodiment of Jesus Christ. We are made in the hands of Yahweh. So Thomas, being a doubter, and you know, the 12 disciples, they all had their unique struggles, right? And for example, Judas, he betrayed Jesus with a kiss. And Thomas was a doubter. So we had a betrayer and we also had a doubter. So this teaches us that we are not to doubt at all that Jesus Christ has risen from the dead. We know for a fact that He is King of Kings and Lord of Lords. And if you are doubting in any way His resurrection, His power, my best advice to you is to seek God for yourself. Do not seek man, because man will always let you down. Man will always forsake you. Being that I am not saying that man cannot be used by God to help you. However, every man can work their own salvation through Jesus Christ. Every man is accountable for his own soul. And one must realize that it is a relationship with Jesus Christ and not with man. So my point is that if you are in doubt in any way, pray and ask God to help you, to show you Himself, to show you His power, to show you His providence, to show you what needs to be shown so that you can believe. And my prayer is that you will not doubt anymore like Thomas did in the Bible. He became a believer. He saw, he touched, he felt the hand that Jesus had a scar in when the nail went through his hand. So I hope that you will choose the way, the truth, and the life. And I pray that this was a blessing to you. Until next time, guys. Shalom.